A few weeks ago, I met with Rod, a schoolteacher who lives in my electorate, and Rod told me about his son, Ollie. Ollie's 19 years old. His dad says he's a good kid and sports obsessed. He loves watching footy. He's at uni studying to be a PE teacher because he wants to share his love of sport with kids. Rod talked about how he and Ollie had always watched football on TV together. And Rod said he'd noticed the increased number of ads before, during and after the games. But the most pervasive and persuasive of these ads were about online sports betting. This year, Sportsbet is one of the AFL's major sponsors. Rod and Ollie always discussed how gambling was terrible, how gambling sucked you in and gave you nothing, and how gambling always made you lose. Rod told me, I couldn't have done much more. Last month, Ollie came to Rod with tears in his eyes. He admitted that he had lost $25,000 in the last 6 months. $25,000. Well, that's a house deposit or a car, or that's Ollie's uni degree paid. One of the things that really bothered me about this story is that this monumental loss happened despite Ollie having support, stability, and every opportunity to avoid getting sucked into gambling. What about the kids who don't have Rod sitting on the couch with them every Saturday? Ollie's embarrassed about what happened to him. He's not going to go and tell his friends about it. Rod pointed out that Ollie and his mates tell each other when they win, but not when they lose. This sense of shame adds to the problem. Young people are not getting complete information about the experience of gambling. They only hear the good stories. And it's everywhere they look. Nielsen data shows a gambling ad is shown every 2 minutes on free-to-air TV in Australia. The gambling industry spent $287 million on advertising in Australia last year, which is 3 times what it was a decade ago. 3/4 of Australian children aged 8 to 16 years who watch sport think betting on sport is normal and can also name one or more sports betting companies. In fact, 1/4 can name 4 or more. My kids aren't that into sport, but they tell me that frequently when playing online games, they get pop-up ads for slot machine style games that require you to spin the wheel in order to close the ad, resulting in a message that you've won free coins and enticing you to keep playing. Almost 3/4 of Australian parents reported being bothered by their children being exposed to gambling ads, and 86% of Australians agree that gambling advertising should not be shown to children while online. Australians spend more on gambling than any other country in the world, and recent estimates suggest that 1.3 million people are at some risk of or are already experiencing gambling problems or harm. We are conditioning our kids to think that gambling is cool and fun.